Uh-oh.
Yeah, thank wow. you.
Don't drop that.
How'd you get your redheads?
I will push his part.
A couple of redheads and dark hair.
That's the way God gave them to me.
Well, you and your family had a nice.
Thank you.
I don't know if you heard the cashier, but she said, are they all yours? And I said, yes. And that's what I always say, because I feel like it's not right to say, oh no, these ones are biological. These ones are adopted. These ones are foster. No, you're staying in my house. You're technically under my care, and I'm going to just say you're mine instead of exposing any story to random strangers at the checkout.
Two random strangers.
So many kids in our house, so let's turn the sound up. You know why? I think it's time for a grandkid roundup.
Grandkid roundup.
Cousin the Lord is
not right to say, oh no, these ones are biological. These ones are adopted. These ones are foster. No, you're staying in my house. You're technically under my care, and I'm gonna just say you're mine instead of exposing any story to random strangers.
She's a perfect golden child, and we super strong, the beauty.
Hey, brother.
Hey, so I wanted to answer this because I have tried repeatedly to bring my twins to a black barber, and I am repeatedly like shunned by the entire barbershop. They won't look at me, they won't deal with me, they won't take my twins. We will stand there for an hour being completely ignored. So yeah, I'm kind of hoping now that the twins' dad is staying out of jail that he can be the one to bring them, because they would not even give me the time of day. Instead of exposing any story to random strangers.
Okay, we would need like an hour to list them all, but here are the top of the list. Fetal alcohol syndrome, fetal alcohol spectrum disorder, reactive attachment disorder, OCD,
OCD, anxiety, autism spectrum disorder, ADHD, gastroparesis,
sleep disorders. Come on, chime in.
Pica.
Pica, oh boy, yeah. Anemia, asthma.
Bipolar disorder. Oh. Mood disorder, impulse control disorder.
PTSD, all 6 of them, PTSD. I'm forgetting stuff.
No, you named a lot of them.
Those are the main ones.
Mm-hmm.
We moved in a little over a year ago. They were 8 and 10 at the time. Is older, and he is the same size as... When they moved in, I took them both for full psych evals. I also had the school district do a full evaluation. You put all of those evaluations together over the past 12 years, and that's his full list of diagnoses. He is small because he has a chromosome 2 duplication, which also displays very similar to autism. He has full fetal alcohol syndrome as well. He has ROPTSD. Add in low IQ genetics, severe trauma, attachment disorder. He was dealt the worst deck of cards in life. And yet he wakes up every single morning happy, full of life, and full of enthusiasm and love.
This dermatology face cream. A couple things. So I'm going to go pick those up at the pharmacy drive-thru.
They usually have all our stuff in a basket here waiting for us. Just like at the post office.
It's the Dougherty treatment.
Okay, so I got...
Okay.
Hydroxyzine.
Oh, okay, good. Yep.
Pimotidine.
Yep.
Non-clinical?
Yep.
Sensory?
Yes.
Alicia?
Yes.
Yes. and I think there was one for, and then should have her aripiprazole too.
All right, hang on.
Okay. I thought I had one more for, but maybe it's too soon. Get, they gotta get aripiprazole, Abilify ready. So that is my excuse to run across the street and grab some coffee. Parenting 10 children with special needs means there are a lot of medications, vitamins, and supplements to sort out. While some have medical needs like gastroparesis, many of our children adopted from foster care battle bipolar genetics combined with their PTSD. 9 of our 10 children are diagnosed with ADHD, as are myself and my husband. So there are 11 of us in this house that are medicated for ADHD. 6 of our adopted children have this diagnosis. However, only 3 of them exhibit the behaviors anymore.
Who, as you look on her paperwork, battles depression, cuts herself, has self-coping mechanisms, is going through trauma. Like, freaking read the paperwork.
So, has this, like, so, I mean, pretty much every single person in my house has an anxiety disorder. Surprise, surprise. And like one of the anxiety things is that like she's gonna get her period like at any moment, any time, and she's not gonna know. So she wears like period underwear every day. And I'm telling you this not to be weird, I'm telling you this because in case you have a kid like mine and that can help you, that underwear, I mean, it's just normal underwear, right? Makes all the difference. In case you're wondering why I have White Claw in my bedroom, I can't keep it in the garage anymore. It was just like disappearing. I don't know. Suspicious activity. So now it has to get locked in my room. Not what everyone keeps their White Claw.
Instead of exposing any story to random strangers.
Hi, so this is something we're still trying to figure out, even 5 years later. We've been in and out of specialists. When
first came into foster care, they knew there was something going on just by physically looking at them because they were malnourished and they have macroglossia, so at that time their tongues wouldn't stay in their mouth. They now stay in their mouth due to tons of therapies. They have ADHD, sensory processing disorder, fetal alcohol spectrum disorder. They go back and forth on an autism diagnosis for them. They currently do have one.
And they have a sleep disorder. They sleep maybe 3 hours a night, even with a ton of medicine to help them sleep. And anxiety disorders, as well as attachment disorder and defiant disorder for. We are currently seeing neurogenetics to try and figure out if there is an underlying genetic condition going on. Thanks for the question. Don't sleep. They both have an undiagnosed sleep disorder that we've been trying to figure out for the past 5 years. They sleep about 3 hours a night.
Broken sleep. Other than that, they're just on the go all day, every day. They want to do sleep studies on them, but in order to get an accurate sleep study, they need to sleep 6 hours.
And that has not happened. Even with 0.3 milligrams clonidine, 10 milligrams melatonin, and 100 milligrams gabapentin, they only sleep 3 hours a night.